the intention braid, your energetic plate. As always, my precious ones, we will recap. The actual reality is something which has already occurred. You cannot change what has already happened. And nonetheless, you try to change your given reality in the current frame. That is why the future does not depend on you. What do you need to do? Order your reality ahead of time, instead of fighting the actuality of your current life. Much of this might sound unusual to you, as for the first time you came across a reality that is unfamiliar and strange. It is still all the same, your reality, to which you are accustomed, but somehow different. Buffling, right? Listen to what I'm saying, and don't be bothering me with questions. Why the film Roller Cube exists, and who shot the film to capture them for the eternity, is not available for comprehension to such a snooky pookies like yourselves. Just be grateful to the High Creator that you're allowed to move the frame, for that is quite something. But you're seriously slacking in your development. You're not even using what you already have. Let me remind you what it means to move the frame. As you know, the past cannot be changed. Forget about the present too. It has already occurred. But you have the opportunity to compose the future, to choose the film role along which the next frame will move. How? You have two control functions, attention and intention. We have already dealt with attention. It is responsible for your state of awareness. Intention accounts for your actions. In order to undertake something, you must first have the idea of it. When you actually come to execute your conceived idea, your intention is realized through action. However, all your actions relate to the current frame and are realized there because your intention is stuck inside it. It is just the same as when your attention gets glued to one of the screens. And just as attention has two screens, there are two intention centers also, inner and outer. The inner center is responsible for all of your basic functionality and is located in the frontal part of the skull. This is your narrow-minded intention. When you concentrate, you wrinkle your forehead. When you intend to do something, you tense your muscles. Your muscles allow you to carry out primitive activities in the current frame. However, the outer center you totally neglect to make use of, even though it accounts for the movement of the future frame. The location of outer center you can identify right now. Every single one of you has an intention braid, the energy plate. It is an energy plexus, similar to an ordinary plate. You can't see it, but you can feel it. It is like a phantom limb, which used to be there. Rather than hanging straight down, it sticks out at an angle to the spine. It's really kind of funny braid. At the tip of this plate is the outer attention center. It is a spot between the shoulders, only not near the spine, but a little away from it. You will find the spot intuitively. The exact distance of it is to no significance. It is enough to focus your attention on the general area, and you will feel where it is. If you cannot feel it yet, for now, imagining is enough. I will tell you about it later, when I described in detail plate with threads, and then you will get it. Operating principle of the outer center is very simple. You transfer your attention to the end of the braid and imagine the picture of any event you would like to attract into your life. Think of it as a one frame. This illuminates the future frame and what you visualized becomes manifested in physical reality. You may ask, my sweets, how is this possible, that this is so simple, and yet you did not know about it, and you did not use it? The thing is that you got stuck down in a current slide. Big time. You're used to looking at what your eyes can see. And they only see what is right in front of you. And you feel that you can only do something about the things your eyes can see. So where are your eyes focused? In the outer screen. And then, as soon as something is not going right, you immerse yourself in the inner screen of your thoughts and feelings. And what are all your thoughts and feelings about? Again, about everything you can see and everything that is happening to you. As a result, your attention does not belong to you, and your intention is subordinate to the script that is not your own. You are capable of coming up with the idea for your own script. It's just you don't know how to bring it to life. Sometimes you dream or want something from your future. Yet, the future frame can only be illuminated from the external intention center. Meanwhile, you are accustomed to using the inner, narrow-minded center. The current slide is your illusion and is a trap. That's how it is. Okay, okay. Don't cry, my sweet darlings. Don't shake your braids in a twist. I will teach you how to escape the trap and how to work with the plate. You will learn everything. Hey, it will be fun.